connects to your mailbox via IMAP. I use Gmail. I'm sure most of you have a Gmail account or can get one. It'll connect right to it. It's definable, so you can change it if you have another IMAP-capable server. It creates three folders. It creates one in your mailbox that you can put the suspected emails in, and it'll read them out of there. And it creates two folders in your local disk, one for processing, one for processed. That way you have some archive of it. The cool thing about it, the library I'm using for the IMAP connection lets me parse the headers right in the mailbox. I don't need to download them. I download them for backup and for other analytics. And then every email that's read is flagged as answered. That way we don't process multiple times on the same email. So I check those key fields that we talked about before, the return path, the reply, some domain checking, some IP lookup checking, and I produce a report. The big thing, again, like I said, is the scoring. So it ranges from 0 to 5. And it's pretty straightforward. It compares fields like return path to reply to. And if they don't match, you don't get a point. If they match, you get a point. So low is bad, high is good. This is the site and the web service API I use for the IP geolocation. And then the who is configurable. This is what a report looks like. So you can see how important it is to score things. You got the number of the email I've analyzed. In this case, there was two in my box. One was good, one was bad. The first one's good. It has a score of 0. I'm sorry, this one's bad, it has a score of 0. This is a phishing email. You can see the subject looks pretty standard. The from, okay, maybe an in-game game master emailed me. But wait a minute, the original email is some guy at Hotmail. That's not good. The originating IP, 22.69. Yeah, that's not a US IP. As we go down, we can see where it came from. The Xmail is Qmail. The country that IP came from is China. The ISP is ChinaNet SH, which is Shanghai. This was based in Shanghai. And then the part where we're doing the Aaron Who Is lookups tells me the domain, and that's restoreconfirm.net. That needs to say blizzard.com. As we can see in the next example, this is the second email. We got a score of 5, which means all the fields that Potato Head checks, they were successful. Blizzard Entertainment, account recovery, that's a US IP. Same component we see that sent the email. And here's an interesting thing. Blizzard is so damn big, they're their own ISP. If you do Whois lookups against some of their domains, the ISP is Blizzard Entertainment. I've never seen that. And then the domain, pardon me, is blizzard.com. So some ideas for future research. The first thing is we need to continue extending Potato Head or other tools like this. Right now, Potato Head produces a flat text report file. It needs some database in the back end. Really give it some power, give it some archiving, and allow you to create different relationships in the reporting and look at data different ways. It needs website integration and interrogation. One cool thing we can do, of course, with even though those bodies are in base 64, we can decode them on the fly. And those bodies are pretty fucked up. They do things like they take other emails they've gotten. Anybody in here ever do an account recovery with Blizzard? No? You? Remember the email you get and it lists like all the stuff they give back to you for each character? What these people do is they pack that into the email to give it some data depth, and they encode it in 64. So all this arbitrary data surrounds the links that they're faking to you, right? Potato Head right now has a little bit of that capability. It's not done yet. It can't follow the chain the whole way. It'll pick up the first couple of links, see that the domains are different, and it'll go to the next link out and interrogate that site, and then it stops. So what are some of the better technologies we need? And this is where I was saying that it's not the email and it's not the browsers. Big question. Anybody work for Blizzard? Anybody gonna admit it? Why is a foreign IP allowed to log into my account? It should never happen. There's different clients. There's a US client, a European client, and an Asian client. Why are they able to lock my account to either my IP or my block? Those are important questions. What in-game security could be created to curb the account compromises? I'm talking about like multi-factor authentication, insecurity. This is a virtual world, right? We spend hundreds of hours in it. Is it identity theft? What percentage of phishing emails result in account compromises? This is a tough nut to crack. I actually posted some surveys on the main general forums for a while, and my account got banned off the forums and the post got removed in seconds. They don't want people talking about it. I'm not saying it's not a conspiracy, but it is what it is. Good question in my mind. Why do we blame the users? You suck, you watch porn, you click on this. It's not their fault. They trust the technology. They should be able to trust it. We need to figure out how to do a better job with it. What can we learn from MMO phishing in order to apply it to our increasingly digital lives? And anybody got any questions? Nope. Yeah, go ahead.
China recently made selling in-game currencies illegal.
I'm sorry?
I thought China recently made selling in-game currencies illegal.
They did. They did. So one of the theories I have right now is, my assumption was China, right? And some of that's the FUD you always hear, especially from the days when it was manual, right? You had these big farming operations in China. One of the possible scenarios is that they're hosting in South Korea now, right? To avoid that. It's something I'm looking at. It's hard to trace. That's where you have to have a lot of data. I've only done a couple hundred emails. I need more. I did that post too on the general forums, and that got taken down real quick. Give me your phishing emails. Yeah, they didn't like that. I don't know. I think it's possible they're just hosting somewhere else. The companies haven't gone away. I can promise you that. They're even more profitable right now. Anybody got anything else? If anybody has any questions they think of later, or you're interested in trying Potato Head, or talking to me about email headers, or WoW, or phishing for WoW, you can email me, let me know. Thanks.